What's going on? It's CVTV, your man Bucks. We're here at Desert Days 2021. Some shit's going down. Time has frozen. We're in the get high zone.
Get up and geek.
We gotta get up, geek. We gotta move our feet. We gotta bust a groove to break the quantum time-space continuum. Can you dig it?
Yeah. Who are we catching today?
You already know we geek to see fucking Kikigaku Moyo Crumb motherfucking. Let me thank on this shit. Let me get the bank on this shit, bro. You already know, fucking Black Angels, Ives Tumor, saw him at fucking Outside Land. They was slapping, bro. Japanese breakfast, Toyo Ma, good God, the boy. Our lover, man's got the fucking bait behind the deck, you know, he's stashing the tech real quick, hey, with Tomo, hey, and then you can't motherfucking miss it, 2 a.m. to the 3 a.m., closing ceremonies with none other than the founding fucking member, Phil Perrone and the bros, Juju and friends. And let me motherfucking say, I have so much fucking respect for the fucking crew here. Bands are like fucking half roadie and shit, like, this is really like a D.I. fucking white environment, bro, and we out here. Space, what's going on?
You already know what's good. Desert Days 2021, we're about to see some action.
Stay tuned. But we right here, right now, in the present, baby. We doing our thing. We about to hit the stage for the first time on Sunday, bro. The last day of the days. Are you ready?
We're at the Greenway Tent. Levitation, based in Texas, is the sister festival to Desert Days, so you already know why they're here.
It's Danny, and we're here with Harry, the owner of Greenway Records.
Yo.
How we doing?
Doing great. Doing great. I can't complain. Day 3, Desert Days, still here, kicking. Yeah. Got all this great stuff from Levitation, so people have been really enjoying it. This is all like leftovers from the 2 weeks ago at our festival, so like we kind of just shipped it all here and have had a lot of great reception from people who are just been super stoked to see it and buy things, which is really cool. Yeah.
So what's it like, you know, being the East Coast company, be able to bring it right here to the West Coast?
It's really cool, honestly. The reception's been great. There's a lot of, you know, there's always been a lot of crossover between Levitation and Desert Days, so like very natural to be here. So many of our artists are literally playing this weekend, so it's like, you know, if we're like, oh, Kikigakumoyo, there's like 3 posters for them, you know? Yeah. So it's a very cohesive and super easy to basically just, you know, do our thing and do it in a really exciting way here. Yeah.
Personal question, who are some of the bands that you're most excited to see?
This whole weekend, today, Black Angels and Kikigakumoyo. Ty Segall was fucking phenomenal as always. George Clanton was fucking insane last night. Honestly, I was like rocked. So many good ones. Place of Buried Strangers, the first night was crazy. So much fun. been hopping around. Spelling was super cool before.
Dude, don't forget Ty Segall.
Yeah, Ty Segall killed it. Yeah, Ty's always freaking just like next level, really. His set 2 days ago was literally next level. It was insane. They were on fire. Yeah. Freedom Band, craziness, yeah.
It sounded like a record.
Yeah, oh my god. And their thing's so, it's like every time they play live, it's like a live album or something. It's like, so always morphing and fucking the versions of songs are always unique and stuff. Super cool. Yeah. Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. Yeah. Yeah.
Do you have anything to say for, you know, say maybe the audience that wanted to come but wasn't able to make it?
Sorry?
Do you have anything to say for maybe like people interested but not able to make it?
Dude, make your way out here at some point. We're gonna Desert Days, Levitation, Austin, Texas. These festivals are like curating, bringing the best artists in the world together in one weekend. I mean, it's hard for some people to be able to find the time, but like, it'll keep happening, and you like, shoot, you know, set your sights on it. You can definitely make it happen. I think it's 100% could be life changing for like anyone in that experience. Yeah, yeah. It was for me, that's for sure. Over the last number of years and years ago when I first came here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Dude, yeah. Thank you so
yeah,
much.
Thank
man.
You guys. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Sacrifice, he went down to the river and he gathered the largest egg that he could find. The scientists insisted that we shouldn't murder these beasts. It's not their fault that they were here, but we needed to get to the bottom of this. So he cracked open the primordial vessel, and out of it came me. Not female, not male, not human, not reptilian, not amphibian. This song is about how horseshit humans are, and how wonderful our planet is, and how we need to stop fucking making everything about ourselves. Beautiful sound, a beautiful, beautiful sound.
Is this your first time at Desert Days?
It is, yeah, first time.
Hell yeah, where'd you travel from?
Vermont.
Nice, so yeah, how's the experience been for you so far?
It's been really fun. I'm really happy I'm here. This is my first music festival ever. So I'm really, really happy this was my first one.
What are some of your first impressions?
First impressions? Really chill, really laid back, non-judgmental, friendly.
Yeah.
Psychedelic.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Yeah, lots of tie-dye. Just like, I don't know.
Sounds very visual.
Very visual, yeah. But also like people who are really here for the music and really here for the experience and like, you know, not here to, well, I guess, yeah, here to get drunk and party. But like, not as a bad thing. But yeah, just good crowd, good vibes.
Yeah, letting loose.
First Desert Days?
Second.
Yeah.
I thought I would be kind of upset about there just being one stage and like with breaks in between, and then it turns out in my old age, like watching music and then meeting all of our friends by like this palm tree in between and like chilling for a moment, yeah. And then the music comes on, we kind of move beyond.
It's easy. Yeah. It's
nice to have a moment.
It's easier to find your friends.
Yeah.
To see every single show.
I don't know how much.
It's nice to like not worry about where your friends are at.
Yeah. Cool. I don't know how much it was undersold on purpose, but like this amount of people is so fucking lovely. So lovely. It's such a change from a lot of festivals. There's just so many people, like bathrooms, lines for getting drinks and food. Like
you appreciate the intimacy.
Yeah, and like when you're on the main stage, there's room to dance for everyone. You can get to the front if you want to. People let you through. It's like
wow, that's I think the way that they put some heavy shit in the first day. You got like Ty Segall on the first day, and then yesterday was just like so chill.
Yeah.
Like got some beautiful jazz and like everything just like. You kind of get to like take a mellow out, yeah. And then kind of like let us go into this last day, which probably
and
arguably the best lineup of the day.
Yeah.
Let's not forget the Americana with like you know fucking Fear of Death, War on Drugs. Yeah. It's like it was very classic that first night. So I'm right there with you.
Yeah.
Hey, so I'm getting excited for some rock tonight.
Exactly. I will take
some experimental stuff. Yeah. Who are some of the artists you guys are excited to see this Sunday?
Kikagaku, baby.
Who's that?
Kikagaku Moyo.
But could you elaborate?
They're a Japanese like psych rock band. They just fucking shred guitars all together and make
but also
sound.
Could be
I'm ready to see a fucking sitar, and I'm ready to melt my brain, dude.
Melted? Okay.
Well, Tomori Ma is going to be the fucking fun closer to like dance to with all of our friends together.
Yeah.
It may be difficult to put into words. If there is a feeling you're searching for, you're trying to manifest, could you put it into one word?
I think happiness. I think that's it. And I think desert. Desert. Yeah.
I would say being.
I think Desert Days does.
She's starting.
Desert Days does the best thing. Like the way that Phil cares about us.
Also, one thing that hasn't been mentioned is the fucking people here.
Amen.
Like everyone here, and I think it has, and I fucking love house
people.
Music, but like having a rock oriented festival weeds out like a lot of people that are just here to party. And you just get people here that are here to like watch music and interact and then dance when you can.
Right.
It's
an all out vibe.
It's a fucking
it's
vibe.
A massive, massive vibe.
I'm gonna answer my own question real quick, and I'm gonna say, one feeling that I get, it's not even I look for, inner peace.
Yeah.
You already know.
Got that outer peace too.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Cruising.
Yeah, first Desert Days or?
First Desert Days.
Wow, man. So first impressions of coming in.
Dude, it looks sick. That's like good vibes. Just could hear the bass coming in. Just like.
Filled with good people and good vibes.
Yeah. Definitely.
Are you guys festival goers or?
I've done one festival before this, Beyond Wonderland.
Yeah.
So this is the second one.
This is my first festival.
Yeah, who are some of the acts that you guys are super geeked on seeing? Soul trash on the speakers, bro.
Really?
It went Super Saiyan 3. Fucking Kai Ken on, bro.
No,
it was fucking gnarly, bro.
Spencer
was like,
tonight.
Chill, bro, chill. And I was like, all right, save that for Kiki Gaga.
I was looking at the set list, who's this? And I was just been listening to
them. Insane. We're about to have a day.
Your Soundwave Sorcerers, bro. The
Soundwave Sorcerers.
Sitar player. Straight up.
Really?
Yeah, he whoops out the fucking chrome fucking
They're all doing that live tonight,
But he took 2 years out of the band, he left, went to India, studied under a fucking guru, came back.
Fuck yeah.
And apparently the last member of the band, I don't know if this is fact, this is just what I heard,
homeless.
They picked him up, and that's the bass player, I believe.
That's so cool.
That's fucking awesome. Yeah. So the band is literally like a super group for Manifest.
Yeah, that's so sick. Fuck yeah.
And they brought all of us here.
Yeah.
That's fucking sick.
What would you say to motherfuckers that thought about coming? They didn't show the fuck up.
They don't show next year. Shoulda, coulda, woulda. Missing out. Yeah, good vibes.
Yeah, good vibes only. And better see your ass next year. Back at the freaking Levitation Greenway tent. He's saying what's good to Harry, the record label owner. You know, he's mentioning, you know, post-flood in fucking New York. A couple months back, shit, hit the fan, but the community came together, you know, and now we're here, we're fucking one with the desert days.
Oh,
What's happening? It's Bucks Bandicoot and Spacey, and we are at the Global Inheritance booth.
Hey, what's going on, ladies?
Having a night.
Yeah, chilling. Just curious, what is Global Inheritance and what's the initiative?
Yeah, so we're an environmental nonprofit based out of Los Angeles, and we have a lot of booths at festivals. And so here we created an interactive experience for Desert Days festival goers. So we have Mother Earth right here and her polygraph machine. So we hook you on up and ask you questions about your sustainability habits. And then based upon your answers, Mother Earth will prescribe you with a dare, whether that's cutting down on plastic water bottles for the next couple months, cutting down your food waste, and stuff like that.
Very chill.
Yeah, and through going through that process, they all get entered to either win band merch that gets given away or Desert Days tickets next year.
Oh, man. Yeah, so there's like a sweet,
sweepstakes. Yeah, VIP upgrades too earlier.
Yeah.
Dude, that's so awesome. And can you guys kind of give us a little background on these like painted one-of-one plastic trash cans?
Yeah, so Danielle was talking about it earlier, but these are all done by individual artists. So they have a program that goes on at Coachella where artists can apply and show their artistic, portfolios and what they would do on one of these trash cans.
Fully.
So yeah, they can do large ones or small ones, but we feature a lot of the large ones at Coachella for like an interactive experience.
Thank you. Thank you. something. That's what art is supposed to do, right? It's not supposed to make you feel like, oh, I can't do that. I would never be able to do that. I want people to see something that they are able to do and that they're capable of doing and fucking try it. Because that's all I did as a painter, right? It's like I felt something and I just went in for it. And I think a lot of the times as human beings, we're told not to do that. We're told, like, that's cute as a kid, that's fun as a hobby, but you can't make a living doing that. You know, you can't make a living being an artist. And so, that made it even more romantic to me. I was like, I want to fucking paint and I want to do what I love. And all I'm going to do is just paint my face exploding. And people are going to respond to it. Why? Because they see something in themselves that is bringing the art to life, right? It's not me. It's the painting. If I wasn't right here and you saw this, you would have the same feeling than if I was trying to explain it to you. If I was trying to explain it to you, maybe it would turn you off to it. You know what I mean?
I agree with you that I like art when it's not explained.
Yeah. And why would you try to fucking explain it?
It's all about your interpretation.
It's about the audience.
But it's
and
cool
what they
once
see.
You gain your interpretation to talk to other people
and
about
see,
theirs
right.
and the artists about theirs, but that's only after you've had time to
There's
digest
some,
it.
And you know what? Exactly. And I've met people that are like,
you don't
they
want
to
start off with.
They
want
to try to explain what's going on and they want to try to, you know, make the audience form some type of sense around their work.
Once you make art, it's up to the ether, it's the universe to decide.
That's it. It's not my art anymore. It's not art at all until the viewer realizes it, absorbs it, and receives it.
Art can be anything. Art can be your garden, go to the grocery store.
It could be how you see water flowing across your hands when you're washing your hands.
Some of the best music I've heard is just birds chirping in the morning.
Bro, it's like nature is the best teacher.
Artist.
Nature is the best artist. Nature is what we have to look to as human beings to make sense of life, you know?
It's what we are.
It's what we are. We're star stuff. Contemplating star stuff, and it took me so long for me to understand that, you know, but the older I got and the more that I realized, like, the science behind it and the chemical alchemy and the physics and all this,
more than meets
the eye. It's more than just being a human.
It's a lot.
It's more than just being a human.
The universe is pretending to be something that, like, an other, to, like, live, you know, to play a game and to just have a dance with itself.
Yeah.
Just have a big pretend.
The universe evolved to the point where it created something that it could now look back
it's
on
like,
itself.
It's like, well, I'm bored, I'm one. I'm gonna spread out and make a bunch of things to play
so,
with.
So now we're looking back onto ourselves as conscious minds, as human beings, as the farthest evolved fucking primate on the planet Earth, right?
Or how we think of ourselves.
Now we're... Good night, girls. Have a good night.
Oh, yes. Turn me up. What kind of tea is this?
Got a solid squad.
That's a good question.
Wow, dude, beautiful.
So you've been here more than this is your seventh time coming?
Thank you. Now, damn, baggage planes like a war zone. Now, Thank you. you'll always remind me. Cause I can't decide if you are my love. I know I can't always be home, but I never left. Don't think like that.
See you all. It means a lot. Thank you so much. We're Toro Ray Ma. I'm Chaz. Let me introduce the band. We got Tony over on the keys. We got Andy on the drums. Mr. Patrick on the bass. Don't keep it all in your head.
asterisk of the year. We did it. Thank you.
Yeah! Woo!
Philly Phil! Juju! What it do? Oh!
We did it.
Another one in the books. Well, you know, we just wrapped up Desert Days 2021. That's CV TV edition. Check it.